in-text questions we are going to discuss. The first question, which of the following matter, chair, love, and all things, you need to identify the matter. So in this, abstract nouns are there. Abstract nouns means such as love, hate, smell. These thought, these things cannot be considered as a matter. The remaining all you can consider as a state of matter. You need to identify the abstract noun in the question. Next question, that why the smell of hot food reaches several meters away, but we need to go close to the cold food. As we all know that particles of matter are continuously moving, they possess kinetic energy. As temperature rises, the particles move faster. Hot food particles have more temperature, therefore they move faster. But whereas in cold food, we have to go close because the particles that carry smell of cold food move slower than compared to the particles that carry the hot sizzling food. So the temperature particles movement is the answer for this question. Now the question, a diver is able to cut through the water in a swimming pool. Which property does this observation show? So what is the property we can see here? If there is no space between the particles of water, can the diver get into? No. So the observation shows that the particles of matter have spaces between them. That is the answer for this question. Next question, what are the characteristics of particles of matter? So you can see that the particles are having inter-particle space, they are having the kinetic energy, they diffuse, and the particles show force of attraction. Not only that, we already have seen the particles have very very small in size, and they diffuse faster at higher temperature, and spaces exist between them. Like that, the properties of matter you can write. Now we know that next question consists of density is equals to mass by volume. Here you need to understand what is density. You see here, copper occupies more mass. All three are having the same amount of space, 1 cm³, 1 cm³, 1 cm³. But if you see, the copper has more mass occupied in less space, therefore copper density is more. Like that, you need to identify, observe, and you have to answer for that question. Next question we are going to see is that write the difference properties in a tabular form: rigidity, compressibility, fluidity, filling of gas container, shape, kinetic energy, and density. You need to table it like this: solid state, liquid state, and gaseous state. Yes, rigidity. Solids are highly rigid, they don't move. Liquids less rigid comparatively to the solids. Gases are not at all rigid. Fluidity. Solids do not flow, but liquids flow from high level to low level. Gases flows in all directions. Like that, you need to write the remaining columns for this particular question. The next question we are going to see that you need to give the reasons that four different questions. That reasons, you can see that a gas fills completely the vessel in which it is kept. Second question, a gas exerts pressure on the walls of the container. Third question, a wooden table should be called as a solid. And fourth question, we can easily move our hands in air but do the same through solid block of wood. Why? These all answers we need to write. The first question, a gas fills container. Why? Because the gases particles are having less force of attraction. They move in all directions, therefore they can fill the container. And second question, due to the kinetic energy of the gas particles, they exert pressure on the container. And third one, a wooden table has definite shape, volume, it is very rigid, cannot be compressed, therefore we can consider the wood as solid. And particles of air are very far apart so that we can move very easily, but whereas wood, no, so it's very difficult to pass through the wood. Next question, liquids generally have lower density as compared to the solids. Next question, how to convert the degree centigrade to Kelvin scale? You need to subtract -273. So here 300K is given in the question, -300 - 273, 27 degrees will be the answer. Now what is the physical state of water at 250 degrees centigrade and 100 degrees centigrade? 250 degrees centigrade, it is clear that water exists in water vapor form. But whereas You can see that as temperature rises, water temperature will raise up to 100 degrees centigrade. Once the water temperature reaches to 100 degrees centigrade, slowly it converts into the water vapor. Therefore, at 100 degrees centigrade, you can understand that it exists as well as liquid as well as water vapor. Okay, Nana? So, water vapor exists as a steam at 250 degrees centigrade. At 100 degrees centigrade, it exists as water vapor as well as a steam. Next question. For any substance, why the temperature of remains constant during the phase change? Because just now we have seen that temperature will not change because that amount of heat will be absorbed by the state of matter. Now, suggest a method to liquefy the atmospheric gases. Here you can see that when we increase the pressure, the volume of the gas will become very, very less. So, by increasing pressure, at the same time, by decreasing the temperature, we can convert the atmospheric gases into the liquid by increasing the pressure as well as reducing the temperature. Next question, why does a desert cooler cool better on a hot dry day? You can see the desert cooler consists of some water and the water will get evaporated. Because of evaporation, we know that the water gets cooled. On a hot dry day, the temperature is high, therefore humidity is low. The rate of evaporation increases with increase in temperature and because of decrease in humidity also. Desert cooler functions on the principle of evaporation. The water takes heat from the hot desert cooler and gets evaporated. The evaporation of water cools the pads and the circulating water. As a result, the incoming air also gets cooled. Next question, how does the water kept in earthen pot becomes cool during summer? Earthen pot consists of tiny pores. During summer, when water is poured in the earthen pot, some of the water seeps through pores to the outer surface. The water molecules on evaporation escape from the tiny pores of earthen pot. As evaporation takes place, that results the lowering the heat of the containing of the remaining water, so the water becomes cool. So now you understood, no? Pot consists of pores and through the pores water will get evaporated. As evaporation takes place, the water in the pot will become cool. Now the next question, why does our palm feel cooled when we put some acetone or petrol or perfume on it? The reason, you can see that as acetone, petrol or fume has very low boiling temperature, when we put some acetone on our palm, the particles gain energy from our palm and evaporates quickly. As evaporation takes place, that palm feels that cooling. So they have lower boiling point, evaporation, because of that it cools. The last question, what type of clothes we should be wear in summer? In summer, we should wear the cotton clothes. Why? Because cotton clothes are good absorbent of water, and as the absorbs water, our body feels cool. We should wear cotton clothes in summer because cotton is good absorber of water and helps in absorbing the sweat and expose it to the atmosphere for easily evaporation. As evaporation takes place, they cool very easily. Thank you.